Poza rządem. Program o organizacjach pozarządowych.
Dear listeners, it's after 8 p.m. We listen to Polish Ambassador, the song titled Vision Fire the Optics, feat. Sean Heffley. Welcome to the program Poza rządem, which every Thursday explores non-governmental side of life. My name is Kasia, and today I'm taking place of Agnieszka, the usual host of this program. I'm really glad to be here, and I would like to use this opportunity to talk about the idea of EVS and about the organization STREAM, the non-governmental organization, one of the most powerful and important I've ever met in my life, in my experience. And I'm not alone here. I would like to ask my special guest to introduce herself.
Hello, my name is Amélie Espériès. I am French, and I am European volunteer in Krakow. I am working in STREAM Association.
Hi, Amandine.
Hi.
How are you today?
Fine. And you?
Good. Little bit stressed?
A little, but it's okay.
Perfect. Amandine, before we talk about EVS, let's explain our listeners a little bit what is STREAM, what they are doing, are they good? You are an expert because you are here already 3 or 4 months.
3 months.
Okay, you are a volunteer at the STREAM organization. So, who they are? What they do?
So, to start, for me, STREAM is a big family because there are a lot of volunteers, Polish volunteers, but also volunteers, European volunteers and all. So, STREAM is an association. The mission is to build an open-minded society about young problems, international education and cultures. STREAM has 4 topics. The first is the integration. STREAM organizes a youth exchange for the young and also adult education projects. And it's a local experiences. After, you have the education. STREAM promotes formal and non-formal education in frame of Leonardo da Vinci program and also EVS.
Okay, seems like you know a lot about this.
Yes.
What about the practice? What are you doing in your work as a volunteer every day?
So, in my work I have 2 principal missions. The first is to promote EVS and STREAM office in Krakow. So with the radio, but also with a forum, with meeting, with my blog, and also with my publication on the website of STREAM office. I explain my experience, but also the experience of other volunteers in Krakow. The other volunteers in Krakow work in kindergarten, in school, but also give languages classes in the library.
Perfect. It sounds like they're really doing a lot. Maybe I would just say some words about the organization. So it was established in Krakow in 2001. It's one of the biggest organizations working with European Voluntary Service in Poland. So with EVS, which Amandine is a representative of this program here. This association initiates and promotes different forms of youth activities. Like, as Amandine said, they organize training, seminars, conferences, public events. Can you maybe remind us and tell to our listeners about some recent event you participated in?
Yes.
It was organized by STREAM?
Yes, yes. For example, you have the International Volunteers Day. In the last December, it's a big event for STREAM Association. And you have also the Migrant International Day for all of expatriates in Krakow and explain the life of expatriates, of Italian, French and all in Krakow and what is the life here.
Okay, really nice. So you participated in this event?
Yes,
yeah?
Both.
You saw it. How to contact them? How to let to know young people who would be interested to participate in some kind of trainings or seminars, or how to reach this organization?
Oh, it's a question complicated because you have to...
How to contact them?
With Facebook, because it's very important. With Facebook, we put a lot of publication for training, for events, and also, for example, for the International Volunteers Day, people come and we talk of the events or all of program. And after, it's okay. For example, people come in the stream office and talk of the opportunities.
Okay, so you said that young people can also visit the organization.
Yes,
they
exactly.
have an office in Krakow?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. What about the website?
The website is composed of four topics. So integration, education, sending and hosting organization for the events, and also for the cooperation between countries. So you can, with the website, you can see a lot of topics about Stream Office.
Okay, so to know more about what they do, what are the possibilities.
Yes, and the
also,
contact.
Okay, and the contact. And we mentioned many times this mysterious abbreviation is EVS. We said that Stream is one of the biggest organizations collaborating with EVS program. So maybe now we will focus on that. And we'll try to encourage, to empower our listeners to be interested and to participate in this program. So maybe in the beginning, I would just introduce very simple in a formal way this idea. So it comes from the program Erasmus Plus. It's part of the it's a very complicated name now. It goes, okay, Education Audiovisual and Culture Executive Agency of European Commission. So the keywords here are European Commission, Erasmus Plus, and EVS, European Voluntary Service. And EVS is a full-time voluntary service for an organization in another country. But let's finish with the formalities. And what about some, like, let's give some practical dimension to this abbreviation. I propose you to discuss our common understanding of the keywords European, voluntary, and service. So, on the beginning, how do you see the European dimension of EVS?
So, for me, European, in the context of EVS, means to start, it's a European program, that you know, and all European citizens who are between 18 to 30 can participate and can to do an EVS, so it's more important. So it's a European, but also non-European people can to do an EVS, for example, Turkish people or Russian people.
Okay, that's interesting. So this, it's even more than European dimension.
Yes, exactly.
What about the places where people can go to do this voluntary service? Is it still in Europe or it's...
You can go everywhere to do an EVS. Of course, in Union European, you have a lot of projects. But after you can go in another countries, for example, in Tunisia or in Russia, in Turkey, a lot of countries.
Okay, it sounds like the young person has really a lot of options.
Yes.
And what about this like practical aspect of the voluntary? So, you know, like the payment and costs. I'm sure our listeners would be interested in that.
So, during the EVS, you contribute to the daily work of the organization. You can work in several fields. For example, with children, with young, in communication, like me, in developing, in environment, and all. There are a lot of fields. It's only 5 or 6. After the project, the EVS can last between 2 and 12 months. It depends on the project. During the EVS, you will receive from accommodation. You will share a flat with volunteers or with students, for example. It depends on the context. You will receive food money, insurance, pocket money. The price of the pocket money depends on the country, and you receive 90% of the return ticket.
Okay.
And during an EVS, you work 30 hours per week.
Okay. Yeah, so it's clear, like, many things are provided, like the food and the accommodation and the transport is covered.
Yes.
Like, it, really, we can say that this program takes care of the volunteer really well. Would you approve this? Is it enough, like, the budget you have for the month? Is it enough for your life in Poland?
Yes. For me, it's enough, but it's enough because with the pocket money, you can trip in the country, for example, because you have a flat, you have a ticket bus, you have internet, you have an insurance. So after, you have a food money, and the pocket money, it's okay, it's for you, it's a free. So
okay, perfect. So you manage.
It's perfect for me. Yes,
it's okay.
You can manage in Poland.
That's nice. Maybe we can speak just in few words about this. Like, it's very really interesting for me, the aspect of service. So is there any ideology behind the project or some kind of values it brings to the volunteer?
For me, the service in the context of EVS means to help an organization, working and bringing your personality and your skills. The nationality, the education, and the social background are not important. For me, it's a value, the most important in the EVS.
Okay.
Everybody can do an EVS. If you have between 18 to 30,
okay,
of course.
Okay, yeah. Of course. Still, yes. Yeah, but it's quite open. Even like the idea that it's organized for young people, it's quite open.
Yes.
It's still 30.
Exactly.
Like we said.
After, when you talk of values, for me, the EVS, the values of EVS have become an European citizens, open-minded, a lot of trip, you meet a lot of people, and it's hello to understand another culture without judgments, because you live with other. So it's very important. And the most important for me is to be motivated and to want to learn a lot of things in several fields. For me, it's the most important, the motivation in the EVS.
Motivation, engagement, the interest in other people, in other cultures.
Exactly.
Like this cultural exchange. So it sounds like it brings, indeed, it does bring like a lot of benefits for someone who participates. And also, like, in the basics, in the very practice of it, like, young people can just learn how, like, particular organization works, how they do, how they face the problems, how they realize their project. So,
yes,
yeah, it sounds it's
really
interesting.
The EVS, it's a real exchange, because the volunteers can learn a lot of things and discover the life, the real life, and also the organization can bring skills of the volunteers and experiment new things, and new ideas, and also for me, it's a real exchange between the organization and the volunteer.
Perfect. So I would just sum it up in a few words. For those of you who are interested to become the to benefit from the European Voluntary Service, if you are young people, less than 30, and you want to learn in practice how a particular organization works, an organization abroad, you're open-minded, interested in other cultures, like interest to develop yourself and to challenge yourself, then you should just apply to get interested more, to approach the special, like, the sending organization in Poland and to apply. Then I would just maybe say you a little bit more, also in few words, how to do it. So, well, first you have to choose the organization where you want to go. There are different strategies on that. Some people choose the countries, some people choose the particular NGOs they are interested in, for example, like
children.
Yes, someone wants to work with children, someone with ecology, with some social issues. So you choose the organization in the database of accredited organizations, and it is possible simply online. Like, it's open for everyone, the access is free. You just visit the website. It's www.mlodzież.org.pl, and then you choose Action 2. So in this Polish version of the website, it will be Akcja Druga. And then you choose, like, I will also say it in Polish. Sorry, Amandine.
It's okay.
Strefa Wolontariusza. And after, you can simply access the database of the accredited organizations. You can also get a lot of information about details of the projects, of the program, sorry, about all we maybe didn't have time to mention now. But this is like the most important thing. I would repeat it again. www.mlodzież.org.pl. Akcja druga.